สวัสดีค่ะ This video we are going to look at the formula and nomenclature of the coordination compounds. This is just going to be an introduction and we are going to look at the simple compound because as from the previous lesson, this group of substances are very big. And sometimes it consists of a very big molecule, very complicated molecule connect to metal ion. So sometimes it would be very difficult to give a systematic name for a very complex molecule. So every compound has a unique name and structural formula. As scientists, you should be able to show a correct formula and give a correct name for substance. All right. In general, we will use the name when we speak about that substance, and when we write, we will show the formula. For example, in the coordination compound in this chapter, when we write, we should write. Show the formula like this. Use the symbol of element to represent what are they. So here we have copper and we have carbon and nitrogen. That is the cyanide group. We have water molecule represented by H and O. How many of hydrogen atom? 2. So we use the subscript to show the number. When we want to talk about this substance, when we speak, we should speak of the name of this one. So this particular one is given a name systematically as diaqua tetracyano copper 6 chloride. So in this video, we're gonna learn systematically how to show formula and name of coordination compounds. In the formula, it is the simple ionic connection. So we show the cation first, followed by the anion. So for example, this compound, this example, we learned previously that anything outside the brackets are cation. So come first here should be cation. After, this is the complex. The complex, this whole thing will be the anion. And when we show the ions, you have to show a corresponding charge. Okay, so K here, potassium. Potassium is element in group number 1, so it has the charge of plus 1. So cation would be K plus 1. How many do you have? You have 2. If you want to show how many cation, you write letter number 2 in front. Okay? But if you ask what is the cation, you just show K plus. So when this is 2 of K plus, so the complex must have the charge of minus 2 here. All right. The second example, the complex is in front, so the complex is a cation here. Outside the bracket, chloride ion has a minus 1 charge, anion. You have only 1 minus 1, so the complex should have the positive charge, plus 1. In the last example, here you have complex in front and complex after. So the first complex is the cation. The second complex is an anion. And they are just one group and one group, so they have the same number of charge. It might not be so clear here why it is 2 plus and 2 minus. This is going to be something that come with experience, that platinum is normally plus 2 charge. So ammonia here is 0. So the first complex should have the positive 2 plus charge. that makes the second complex as a 2 minus charge. Alright? Anyway, don't worry about the last example. If I ask you to do any question or exam, it will be very clear what is the charge of complex and counter ion. Okay? In the complex, when you show the formula, we will follow this pattern. Bracket represent the complex. Okay, in the complex we show metal first, followed by ligands. Ligand here show in plural, so you can have more than one type of ligand. You just write it one after another. Okay, and if your complex is ion, you show the charge, either cation or anion. You can show plus charge or minus charge. Alright? The formula is simple like this. Next, how do we call them? Giving name. So there are systematic naming for complex and for counter ion. As you see, complex can be neutral cation or anion, as well as counter ion can be cation or anion. We will look at giving name for counter ion first because it's simpler. Name of counter ion. Counter ion can be single ion, either positive or negative, or it can be polyatomic ion, group of atom with charge. We name this counter ion the same way that we name the ion for ionic compound. So if we have counter ion as cation, we just give the name by using the element name or the name of the group of ion. For example, potassium ion, sodium ion, calcium ion. Or if we have polyatomic ion, the positive one, just one example, that is ammonium, NH4+1. Alright? Or you can have aluminium, that is the cation, counter ion as well. If the counter ion is an anion, in the ionic compound anion, you're gonna change the ending of the element with the IDE, like chloride, fluoride, iodide, something like that. Or you give the name of the group of ion, sulfate, carbonate, nitrate, etc. Okay? This is simple enough. Alright? The more complicated one is the name of complex. Complex can be neutral, can be cation, or can be anion. To separate between the complex that is cation or neutral from the complex that is anion, the name is slightly different. Look at the name of cation complex or neutral complex first. This is the pattern. When you're giving name, you give the name of ligand first with prefix to tell how many group of ligand, and then followed by the metal name and its oxidation number in parentheses. And this oxidation number is shown in the Roman numeric. For example, these are list of prefix: mono for 1, di for 2, tri for 3, tetra for 4, etc. This is the name of ligand. Name of ligand: either cyano, iodo, amine, aqua, etc. This is the name of metal: chromium, iron, copper, zinc, etc. And this is the oxidation number. It can be any number 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. Alright? For the anion complex, the name is slightly different. Different where? Different at the metal's name. If the complex is cation or neutral, we just give name of metal as it is, as the name of element. But if the complex is anion complex, the metal names, we add the ATE afterward, like chromium, change to chromate. Zinc, change to zincate. And this is in bold here. This name change completely from iron to ferrate, copper to cuprate. Okay, everything else are the same. So we will focus on the name of ligand and name of metal. นะคะ I bring this slide back to you last time in the terminology. I said we should bring back this slide because this is the name of ligand. Okay, here you have to memorize this name. Water molecule as ligand, it will be called aqua. Ammonia molecule as ligand, it will be called amine with two M's. Amine. Okay. Carbon monoxide molecule as ligand, it will be called carbonyl. And this name. For the anion, common one, fluoride ion. As ligand, it will be called fluoro. Chloride ion, as ligand, it will be called chloro, bromo, iodo, oxo, hydroxo, cyano, and some of these. Okay, I make a note here. This name that I show you on this slide are common name for ligand. IUPAC name are slightly different to this, but I'm not gonna talk about it in this video. If you see some other name other than this in internet or textbook, just make sure that you learn about this. The IUPAC name may be different to this, but the common names are preferred here in this video. And these are the name of metal in the complex ion. If the complex ion is cation, as I said, we just use the element name. If the complex is an anion, we add the ending of element name with ATE. So aluminum become aluminate, chromium become chromate, cobalt become cobaltate. And these are special element where name for cation is just the simple element name, but name for anion is changed. Okay, so you have to memorize this again. Copper change to cuprate, gold change to aurate, iron change to ferrate, lead is plumbate, silver argentate, tin stannate. Okay, only six of them. All right, now these are two examples where I categorize the part of the name for you. This is the formula, right? Complex cation. This is complex anion. Complex cation. This is called tetraamine dichlorocobalt 3 ion. categorize each part of the name. Tetra is the prefix of ligand. The first ligand is amine, NH3, amine. How many? 4, tetra. The second ligand is chloride. How many? 2. So put the prefix for 2, di. Ligand name change to chloral. And then metal's name cobalt, because this is the cation complex, give the name of metal cobalt. This is the oxidation number, oxidation state, 3. The second one, this is the complex that is anion, 2-, having a name as diamine tetrachloral cobaltate, 2-. So if you just are given the name of the complex, you see cobalt, you must know that this complex has a positive charge. If you see cobaltate, you must know that this complex has a negative charge. All right. Di is a prefix for ligand amine. Tetra is a prefix for ligand chloral. Tetra means 4. Di means 2. Cobaltate is the metal's name for anion complex, and this is the oxidation state. Okay. Now let's practice giving name for this coordination compound. So when you see this, the bracket here is the complex and it is in front, so it must be cation. This Cl or chloride is outside the bracket, so it is a cation. It comes after the cation, so this is your anion. So separate these two parts first, cation, anion. I said earlier that when we talk about ions, you have to put a corresponding charge correctly, okay? So chloride here, -1. Only one group, therefore complex has the charge, +1. Complex is the cation, counterion. Giving name of complex ion, that is a cation, we follow this pattern. Ligand first, and then metal ion name and oxidation number. Counterion name end with IDE or name of ion as polyatomic ion. So name the complex ion. What do we have? We have ligand, water molecule, how many? 4. We have ligand chloride ion, how many? 2. And we have metal, chromium. We have to look for oxidation number. And this complex has the charge, +1. Name for counterion, we can give that straight away, very easily. Cl, -1, is called chloride. All right. So work out from here. Prefix 4, right? 4 is tetra. What is this? Aqua. So this makes tetra aqua. 2 prefix di. This ligand is called chloral. Okay. And this metal for the complex ion, that is cation, is called chromium. Work out oxidation state. So this is tetra aqua dichloral chromium. The oxidation state shown here is 3. Where from? Aqua, 0 charge, doesn't count. Chloral, -1 charge, you have 2 of them, so -2. -2 plus x equal to +1. So x is +3. So this is the oxidation state. So add this and this together. The full name is called tetraaqueous dichloromethanol 3 chloride. Okay, do you get that? Okay, let's see another example. This is the coordination compound. This time we have cation in front, which means this is a positive charge. Complex must be a negative charge. So separate cation and anion like this. Cation, potassium group 1 metal plus 1 charge. How many? 3. This is the anion. Cation has a total charge of plus 3. Complex must have the charge of minus 3. Alright. Cation, name, element. So this is called potassium. Okay. Cation is a positive charge. Name the element. So this is called potassium. We don't give the name 3 here, or tripotassium is incorrect, นะคะ. Just potassium. For the complex anion, we use the pattern like this. Prefix ligand metal end with ATE and oxidation number. So what is ligand here? CN cyano. How many? 6. What is the prefix for 6? Hexa. What is the name for this element Fe? In the anion complex, it's called ferrate. So this is hexa cyano ferrate. Oxidation number is 3. Where from? Cyano has the charge minus 1. 6 of them, so make minus 6. X minus 6 equal to minus 3. So X is plus 3. So the full name is potassium hexacyanoferrate 3. Now, giving the name and ask for the formula. Please show the formula of this coordination compound. Tetraamine bromo chloral platinum 4 chloride. So, a very long name here must be complex ion, and it comes in front. So it would be cation. This is the cation, and it must be anion. So the cation is tetraamine bromo chloral platinum 4. The anion is chloride. Okay. Change name to formula. Okay. We get this. Come from tetraamine 4 ammonia molecule. Bromo Br minus 1. Chloral Cl minus 1. Platinum 4, so Pt 4 plus. Platinum 4, Pt 4 plus. Okay, and this is Cl minus 1. Okay? And then you have to rearrange this, because in the formula, you have to write metal first, right? Metal first and followed by ligand, subscript with the number of ligand. Okay. So we also need to calculate the charge of this complex ion. And we do this. Rearrange, add up oxidation number. So this is 0, minus 1, minus 1, plus 4, equal 2 plus. Okay. Again, this is 0 for ammonia, minus 1 here for bromo, the second minus 1 for chloral, plus 4 come from this platinum 4. Okay, so add this up, make a total charge of positive 2. So this is the charge of the complex. So you get your cation like this. Metal first, followed by ligand, amine, 4 of them, bromo just 1, chloral just 1. This is the total charge of complex ion. Okay, and this is the 2 positive, this is minus 1. So how many cation do you need? 2, to make a total charge of 0. So this is the full formula, you need 2 of the cation. Alright, so now we learn how to give name for coordination compound, and from the name we can give formula for the coordination compound as well. Now, can you answer this? A student writes the name of the compound here as aqua pentaamine cobalt dibromide. The question is this correct name? If not, provide a proper systematic name. Is this correct? Think about that. The answer is it is not correct. Why not? First of all, dibromide here is already not correct. Okay. And for the coordination compound, metal must have oxidation number. This doesn't have oxidation number. So the correct systematic name for this compound should be pentaamine aqua cobalt 2 bromide. Okay. Pentaamine aqua cobalt 2 bromide. So hopefully you got this, nakha. And if you want to learn more in detail about nomenclature for coordination compound, read from the attached document. สวัสดีนะคะ